You're watching the TC MMA podcast.
Now, the new main event changed just this week. It's a middleweight division fight. Two big guys early in their career. Mansur Abdul-Malik, 5-0. Wes Schultz, 6-1. Doesn't get better than this. You might, you know, if they're in the main event, despite the lack of fights, and there's a finish, that guy's getting into the UFC. So all eyes will be on this fight. Make no mistake about it. So let's get into the main event, middleweight division, right now. In the middleweight division at Dana White's Contender Series, you got Mansur Abdul-Malik taking on Wes Schultz. All right, so Contender Series is back, and you got two good ones here. Abdul-Malik 5-0, Schultz 6-1, both guys 6-2. Abdul-Malik is 26 years old, Schultz is 27, and Abdul-Malik has a 4-inch reach advantage, 80-76. So keep that in mind. Now he's 5-0. He's got 4 wins by KO, 1 by submission. So he's looked good. Fought an LFA the last time out. Now, Schultz has been fighting in LFA, where he's got 2 KOs, 3 submissions, 1 decision. Only loss was to Dylan Buca. Heard that name. Lost that fight by decision, right? In the last 3, he's won 2 by KO and 1 by submission. So that's what causes me some worry for Abdul-Malik, who I know can KO people. Yeah, he's got 1 submission, but I just have a feeling that Wes Schultz is going to be better on the ground, and he probably learned something from the loss that he sustained, right? And he's ready for this environment. This is USA versus USA. Not that that matters, but the point is no matter who wins, there's no bias here. The bottom line is I think Wes Schultz is just going to be better on the ground. He's going to be able to limit Abdul-Malik, which will allow him to get the victory, but it may not be good enough to get him into the UFC unless he can get the submission. We'll have to wait and see, but I still believe, in my opinion, Wes Schultz wins this fight to move to 7-1, middleweight division, Dana White's Contender Series. Yeah, and at the time, it was a co-main event, so even if there's a decision and it's a really good fight, there's a good chance that he still gets into the UFC, right? Because it's the main event, and it's a light heavyweight division fight. It's a middleweight division fight. And, you know, you got a lot of good competitors in the middleweight division. It's pretty deep right now, so it's not guaranteed, but you can always use another middleweight fighter, right? You got 4 or 5 guys right now. If Hamzat can get his win against Whitaker, then you got 5 guys in that division, and it's getting deeper and deeper, but you still can add more. So look for him to make his way into the UFC. So that's week 1 of the Contender Series. We're going to be back next week with week 2. Something new we're doing this year. We want to cover the Contender Series even more because we're starting to realize, man, that these guys that come through the Contender Series end up doing some big things in the UFC and sometimes even work their way up into title contention.
He's gonna fight, wait, he's gonna fight, wait, hold your breath till the end of the night. Last fighter call, UFC at its height, yeah. Bringing that thunder with all his might, saying, step up, wanna fight?
Huh?
Hold up, think twice. Gladiator assassin, reckless, no abandon. Walk through that cage, he'll leave your ass.